Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Fluid Mechanics and Machines. This is lecture number 5.1, 5th chapter, 1st lecture. The topic is Fluid Dynamics. So, we are going to discuss about the Fluid Dynamics. The topic for today's discussion, so in this lecture, we are going to derive the Euler's equation of motion and the Bernoulli's equation. And in the earlier lecture, previous 4 chapters, we studied about the types of fluid flow and we derived the continuity equation. We discussed the fluid kinematics in the earlier lecture, the velocity, acceleration, velocity potential function, stream function, everything we have discussed. The learning outcome for this lecture, so at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to derive the Euler's equation of motion and the student will be able to derive the Bernoulli's equation. The study of fluid motion with the forces causing the motion, causing the flow is called as fluid dynamics. So, earlier we studied the fluid kinematics where we described the fluid motion in terms of velocity, acceleration and other fluid flow parameters. Now, here in addition to the fluid motion, we are going to discuss about the forces causing the flow. That is what called as fluid dynamics. And the dynamics of fluid is analyzed using the Newton's second law of motion. So, this law is we studied earlier at lower classes. In the engineering mechanics also, we studied the Newton's second law of motion. The net force acting on the fluid element in a particular direction is equal to the rate of change of momentum in that direction. The net force acting in the fluid element in a particular direction is equal to the rate of change of momentum in the direction. Or the simplified version, the net force acting on the fluid element in a particular direction is equal to the mass of the fluid element multiplied by the acceleration in that direction. So, the rate of change of momentum is mass into acceleration. So, change of momentum, rate of change of momentum is the mass into acceleration. So, the net force is equal to mass into acceleration, mathematically F equal to ma. So, the second law of motion, Newton's second law of motion, mathematically given by F equal to ma, where F is the force, m is the mass of the fluid, and A is the acceleration. And there are different types of forces present in the fluid flow. So, one is gravity force, or it is also called as body force, the force due to the weight of the fluid. Then pressure force, Fp is the pressure force, Fv is the force due to the viscosity or the viscous force. So, any fluid, it has got some viscosity, the force given by the viscosity of the fluid, it is called as viscous force. And Ft, force due to the turbulence. So, the fluid flow, we studied about the laminar flow, turbulent flow. The turbulent flow, there is turbulence created in the fluid flow. So, the force due to the turbulence is Ft. And Fc is the force due to the compressibility of the fluid. So, we classified the fluid flow into compressible flow, incompressible flow. So, the compressibility of the fluid, so that gives some force, that is called as force due to the compressibility of the fluid and the force due to the surface tension. So, Fs is the force due to the surface tension. So, the total force equal to the most of the fluid flow, the force due to the compressibility and the force due to the surface tensions are negligible. So, the net force equal to the F equal to Fg, body force or the gravity force, Fp, pressure force and Fv, viscous force and Ft is the turbulent force. And when you derive the expression for Fg, Fp, Fv and Ft and substitute in that equation, then the equation is called as Reynolds equation of motion, which is useful for analysis of turbulent flow. So, the Reynolds equation is useful, so it is for turbulent flow. So, the combined 4 forces, right? So, the gravity force, pressure force, viscous force and the turbulent force. Now we simplify one by one. So we take the most simplified situation. So next is simplification. We take only laminar flow. So for the laminar flow, the force due to the turbulence is negligible. Ft is equal to 0. Then the equation becomes F total force equal to the force due to the gravity, body force, pressure force and the viscous force. And this equation is called as Navier-Stokes equation, which is useful for analysis of viscous fluid flow. That also we will discuss. Viscous flow we will discuss later stage. So the Navier-Stokes equation is for useful. It is the equation for the viscous flow analysis. Now we take the ideal fluid where the effect of viscosity is negligible. Fv equal to 0. Viscous force equal to 0. Then the equation is F equal to Fg plus Fp, where Fg is the body force or the force due to the gravity and Fp is the pressure force, and this equation is called as Euler's equation of motion. So here we are considering only two forces, the force due to the gravity Fg and force due to the pressure of the fluid. That is what the Euler's equation of motion. Now the Euler's equation of motion, the only two forces are considered, pressure force and the body force, or the force due to the gravity of the flowing fluid. Also the fluid assumed to be non-viscous, so that the pressure force acting in the normal to the surface. So we consider a fluid element of length delta x, delta y, delta z in the xy z direction. So you take the fluid element, so small fluid element, so delta x is the length in the x direction, delta y is the length in the y direction, and delta z is the length in the z direction. Consider a point P. So here you consider a point P at the xyz. So the position is xyz in the fluid element, at which u, v, w are the velocities in the xy z direction. So for point P, u is the velocity in the x direction, v is the velocity in the y direction, and w is the velocity in the z direction. And rho is the mass density of the fluid element. And P is the intensity of pressure of the fluid element. And x, y, z are the components of body forces per unit mass. So these are all the points. So P is the point, rho is the density, P is the intensity of pressure, and x, y, z are the component of body forces per unit mass. Now we are going to calculate the various forces of the fluid element. First, the various forces acting on the fluid element are, first body force in the x direction, Fgx equal to x into rho into delta x, delta y, delta z. So delta x, delta y, delta z is the volume of the fluid element, rho is the density, and x is the unit body force, unit gravitational force. Similarly, body force in the y direction, Fgy equal to y into rho into delta x, delta y, delta z, and the body force in the z direction, Fgz equal to z into rho into delta x, delta y, delta z. Then we take this fluid element, with reference to the fluid element, we calculate the body force in the x direction, body force in the y direction, and body force in the z direction. Then pressure force in the x direction. So look at the element. So here the fluid is entering, the pressure is acting here. The intensity of pressure is P, and the area of the surface is delta y, delta z. So the force, the pressure force acting normal to the surface is P into delta y, delta z. And similarly here, the force acting normal to the surface, P plus dou P by dou x into dx. Dou P by dou x into dx into delta y, delta z. It is not 2P, it is dou P by dou x. Now, Fpx equal to P into delta y delta z minus P plus dou P by dou x delta x into delta y delta z, that is equal to, so simplifying this becomes minus of dou P by dou x, because the plus P into delta y delta z minus P into delta y delta is getting cancelled. So finally, what is left out? Minus dou P by dou x delta x, delta y, delta z. Similarly, in the y direction, Fpy equal to P into delta x, delta z. So, P, y direction, so the force acting here,
the area normal to the surface is delta x, delta z, and P is the force intensity of the pressure force, minus P into dou P by dou y into delta y into delta x, delta z. So, this is again what is left out, minus of dou P by dou y, delta x, delta y, delta z. And the z direction, the pressure force in the z direction, FPZ equal to P into delta y delta x minus P plus dou P by dou z, delta y delta x. Again, minus, what is left out? Minus dou P by dou x delta y delta z. Then the acceleration in the x direction. So, this equation, these three equations we derived already in the fluid kinematics. Acceleration x direction, Ax equal to dou e by dou t plus u into dou u by dou x plus v into dou u by dou y plus w into dou u by dou z. And acceleration in the y direction, Ay equal to dou v by dou t plus u into dou v by dou x plus v into dou v by dou y plus w into dou v by dou z. And acceleration in the z direction, Az equal to dou w by dou t plus u into dou w by dou x plus v into dou w by dou y plus w into dou w by dou z. Now, the Newton's law, second law of motion in the x direction, Fx equal to m into Ax. So, Fx equal to Fgx plus Fpx. So, the body force in the x direction, pressure force in the x direction equal to mass into acceleration in the x direction. Now, you substitute the values, substitute for the body force and the pressure force in this equation. So, xp delta x delta y delta z minus dou p by dou x delta y delta z equal to. So, m equal to density into volume. Mass equal to density into volume. So, rho into delta x delta y delta z into acceleration the x direction. Dou u by dou t plus u into dou u by dou x plus v into dou u by dou y plus w into dou u by dou z. Now, the three terms, delta x, delta y, delta z, is the volume of the element in all the three equations. Three terms are neglected. So, finally, the net force in the Newton's second law of motion in the x direction, x minus 1 by rho dou p by dou x equal to dou u by dou t plus u into dou u by dou x plus v into dou u by dou y plus w into dou u by dou z. So, this is the body force and this is due to the pressure force and this is the acceleration. The right side is the acceleration. Similarly, in the y direction and the z direction. So, y direction, y minus 1 by rho dou p by dou y equal to dou v by dou t plus u into dou v by dou x plus v into dou v by dou y plus w into dou v by dou z. And z direction, z minus 1 by rho into dou p by dou z equal to dou w by dou t plus u into dou w by dou x plus v into dou w by dou y plus w into dou w by dou z. So, the Euler's equation of motion in the three directions are given here. So, x direction, first equation, second equation, y direction, and third equation, z direction. X minus 1 by rho dou p by dou x equal to dou u by dou t plus u into dou u by dou x plus v into dou u by dou y plus w into dou u by dou z. Similarly, y equation, y minus 1 by rho dou p by dou y equal to dou v by dou t plus u into dou v by dou x plus v into dou v by dou y plus w into dou v by dou z. And z direction, z minus 1 by rho dou p by dou z equal to dou w by dou t plus u into dou w by dou x plus v into dou w by dou y plus w into dou w by dou z. So, this is the Euler equation for ideal fluid flow in three-dimensional flow field. But normally, this equation, complete form of the equation, we are not going to deal with the three-dimensional flow. Normally, we take a one-dimensional flow at this level and we simplify this equation for a one-dimensional flow. So, automatically, the second term y direction, z direction are deleted. So, we use only the x equation, x direction equation and using that equation, we can further simplify or further derive the pressure quantity or velocity of the flow field. Now, for our under third semester fluid mechanics, we take the Euler's equation, we derive the Euler's equation of motion by considering the motion of the fluid element along a steam line. So, this is the steam line. So, the flow of the fluid element is moving along the steam line. Consider a cylindrical fluid element along the steam line of cross sectional area dA and the length dS. So, the cross sectional area is dA and length equal to dS. So, this is the fluid element we are considering and which is moving in the streamline direction. So, the force, the various forces acting. So, the body force equal to rho g into dA into dS. Rho g into dA into dS. And the pressure force is P dA here and P plus dou P by dou S into dS into dA on the opposite side. So, this is rho g into dA dS. So, the various forces acting on the fluid element. So, the pressure force in the direction of the flow P into dA. Pressure force in the opposite direction of the flow P plus dou P by dou S dS into dA. And the body force due to the weight of the fluid element rho g into dA into dS. So, these are all the, so this is rho g, read as rho g dA into dS. And let theta is the angle between the direction of the flow and line of the action of the body force. Then the applying second law of motion. So, the net force P into dA minus P plus dou P by dou S dS into dA minus rho g d dS into cos theta, that is equal to rho dA dS into AS. So, rho dA dS is the mass of the fluid element and AS is the acceleration of the fluid element fluid along the streamline direction. So, A is the acceleration in the x direction. So, the s direction. So, we will calculate velocity. So, now we find out velocity is a function of s and t. So, s is the in the streamline direction and t is the time and which is function of s and t. So, we differentiate now AS equal to velocity, differentiating velocity with respect to time. So, dv by dt. This dv by dt, so we have v is a function of two parameters. So, dou v by dou s ds by dt plus dou v by dou t into ds by ds. So, the ds ds is getting cancelled. So, AS equal to this ds by dt is the velocity. Change in the displacement with respect to time is the velocity. So, velocity v into dou v by dou s plus dou v by dou t. If the flow is steady flow, so dou v by dou t equal to 0. So, finally, the acceleration in the streamline direction AS equal to v into dou v by dou s. So, we substitute this AS term in the previous equation. So, substituting the value of AS and simplifying P dA minus P into dou P by dou S dS into dA minus rho g dA dS cos theta equal to rho dA dS into AS equal to V into dou V by dou S. Now, the P dA is getting cancelled because plus P dA minus P dA getting cancelled. And look at the remaining terms. We have ds dA, ds dA and ds dA. So, that is also getting cancelled. So, finally, what is left out? So, here we have dou P by dou S and here we have rho g cos theta and right hand side we have rho into V into dou V by dou S. Now, cos theta equal to ds dz by ds. So, looking at the equation, looking at the diagram, theta cos theta equal to dz by ds and substituting for cos theta dp by dz. So, the dp by ds, right, you take everything to the other side, dp by ds plus rho g into dz by ds plus rho v into dv by ds equal to 0 and dividing by density 1 by rho dp by ds plus g into dz by ds plus v into dv by ds equal to 0 and differential form. So, dp by rho plus g into dz plus v dv equal to 0. So, ds is the direction in which we are integrating, we are differentiating, so that is neglected. So dp by rho plus g into dz plus v dv equal to 0, and this equation is known as Euler's equation of motion. So finally, it is dp by rho, the change in pressure with, by density, g into dz plus v dv equal to 0. This is the Euler's equation of motion. So this equation you have to remember. So for further in the chapter, we will be solving, you will be using this equation for further discussion. You have to remember, for all the flow measuring devices, we will be using this equation. In future also, we will be using this equation for derivation. Now, the next equation is Bernoulli's equation. So, the following assumptions are made in the derivation of Bernoulli's equation. The fluid is ideal fluid, that is non-viscous. The flow is steady flow. The flow is incompressible. And the flow is irrotational flow. So, these are all the assumptions for the Bernoulli's equation. And the Bernoulli's equation may be obtained by integrating the Euler's equation. So, we have the previous equation, Euler's equation, integrating integral dp by rho plus integral dz plus integral v dv equal to constant. Right side integrating, it is constant. So, integrating p by rho plus gz plus v square by 2 equal to constant. So, here p by rho g plus z plus v square by 2g equal to constant. So, rho g equal to specific weight. So, rho density, g is the acceleration due to gravity, that is specific weight. So, p by rho plus v square by 2g plus z equal to constant. So, there are two terms in the Bernoulli, three terms in the Bernoulli's equation. First, p pressure term, p by rho g, which is p by w specific weight, plus v square by 2g plus z. So, there are three terms in the Bernoulli's equation, and the various terms in the Bernoulli's equation represent the energy possessed by the flowing fluid. So, the Bernoulli's equation is the energy equation of the flowing fluid. So, the three energy terms are p by w specific weight equal to pressure head or the static head. V square by 2g is the velocity head or the kinetic head. And z is the potential head or the datum head. So, the energy, pressure energy, velocity energy and the potential energy. So, sum of all the three energies is the total energy of the fluid flow, which is given by the Bernoulli's equation. The sum of the pressure head, velocity head and the datum head is the total head or the total energy per unit weight of the fluid. And the Bernoulli's equation states that in a steady irrotational flow of incompressible fluid, the total energy at any point is constant. That is what given. So, p by rho plus v square by 2g plus z equal to constant. So, Bernoulli's equation states that for steady irrotational flow of the incompressible fluid, the total energy at any point is constant. So, that you have to remember, and these terms also we have to remember. The Bernoulli's equation is very important for our fluid mechanics study. So, when the Bernoulli's equation is applied between two points in a steady flow situation, so we will get p1 by w plus v1 square by 2g plus z1 equal to p2 by w plus v2 square by 2g plus z2. And this is the basic equation for fluid mechanics in applying the equation for measuring flow measuring various flow measuring devices. We have to calculate the flow using this Bernoulli's equation. And considering the viscous losses in the Bernoulli's equation, the real fluid, for a real fluid, so this equation is for ideal fluid, and we can modify this equation for a real fluid where the viscous losses are considered, then the equation becomes p1 by w plus v1 square by 2g plus z1 equal to p2 by w plus v2 square by 2g plus z2 plus hl, where hl is the loss of the head between points under consideration. So, this loss due to the viscous losses. So, we stop here. So, the derivation of Euler's equation and the Bernoulli's equation, it is very important. You have to remember the Euler's equation and you have to remember the Bernoulli's equation for your further study or for solving the problem in future. So we stop here. So these are all the books I published in various mechanical engineering subjects. So here you can find the subject, the book called Fluid Mechanics in Machinery, which you can use for further information and problems in the fluid mechanics and machinery. And I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures for all the subjects in the list, and you can subscribe the channel and use the video lectures for your better learning and passing the GATE examination. So thank you for watching. So please post your comments on the comments box. So you subscribe the channel so that you will get the updated video. You can write to my mail ID for any clarification on the subject. So we'll meet again in another video lecture. We'll continue this fluid dynamics in the next lecture with the flow measuring devices.